I'm Christine Reed, and we're here today talking with Lane Langley and his wife Candida, kind of sitting in on their photo shoot here with their amazing 1961 Cadillac convertible, and it's a Series 62. Series 62, I guess, was from about 1941 to 1964. I guess they called it 6200 sometimes later.
That's correct.
You two have been having a lot of fun with this car, I understand.
Yes, we have. Mm-hmm.
In particular, at the Dana Point Concours recently.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yeah, the Dana Concours was the fourth event that I've shown the car in. Won a Best in Show the first show, and then second show, I won second place in the Cadillac LaSalle Club show.
It must have been a lot of fun to put together.
It was a lot of fun. It was a lot of work, but it was just great fun putting it together and being there to host it. And, mm-hmm. The way you really get to know someone is drink with them.
Mm-hmm.
And we did a lot of that.
And, you know, very
a lot nice. Of drinking.
Did Fritz get to go?
Fritz doesn't like the car shows, and he likes to just...
He doesn't like grass.
He doesn't like grass. That's one thing. And he named a line of furniture after Fritz, Lazy Boy. So he's not a real energetic dog. That's what we like about him.
My boyfriend's back and you're gonna be in trouble.
Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend.
When you see him coming, better cut out on the double.
Hey la, hey la, my boyfriend's back.
You've been spreading lies that I was untrue. So look out now, cause he's coming after you.
Back in 1961 when this car came out, mm-hmm. trying to think, I think that was the year that Kennedy was inaugurated.
That's correct.
And then he wanted to do the trip to the moon.
Right.
Gas was 27 cents a gallon.
That's correct. So you didn't, wow. Mileage wasn't real important in those days.
Yeah. So, and when you think about the technology, mm-hmm. This car has some really neat features.
Well, it had options that you didn't have in a lot of cars. I mean, air conditioning wasn't an option that you got in most cars in those days. And actually, this one, they didn't buy that option when they originally bought this car.
Mm-hmm.
This had a wonderful radio called a Wonder Bar.
The Wonder Bar,
and you turn the radio on, and then you push the Wonder Bar, and it would go to a station, whatever station was up. It's kind of like the seek button on the cars today.
Uh-huh.
So it was except it was very mechanical instead of digital. So had that, it had a light dimmer, automatic dimmer that sat on the dash. This one didn't come with that also.
Uh-huh.
And it would actually dim the lights. Sense and dim lights when other cars were coming down the roads with their lights on. So
nice.
That was kind of neat.
Very nice.
You could get cruise control, which was something that just wasn't, people didn't even know about in those days.
Yeah.
So there were a lot of things you could buy on this 61 Cadillac that weren't available too many years before anyway.
Tonight you're mine.
I guess it's obviously a very large, long car, and the crease is very crisp and sophisticated, very horizontal lines, and it's a more traditional automotive architecture where I guess the 59 harkened back a little bit more to aircraft.
Right.
My dad said that engineers were very happy with the crease for other reasons, not just the styling, but also it strengthened the body of the car, so they could use a lighter weight steel gauge.
They took the weight all the way down to like 5,000 pounds.
And there you go. Drives, your favorite cruises here?
Well, we live in Dana Point,
mm-hmm.
so we're right on the coast, and so to get in it and drive north towards Laguna Beach, and then on to Newport Beach, and go down and cruise the peninsula, and once in a while we go over to Balboa Island and take the ferry across. It's like having our own open boat.
Nice.
And then we'll cruise down to, on the peninsula, down to the coast again, and through Huntington Beach, and down to Seal Beach, and come back, and on a Saturday afternoon, that's about a four-hour drive. And lots of thumbs up, and everyone wants to know what year it is. And it's amazing how many people don't know what it is. You know, they'll say,
really?
What is it? Yes.
I noticed that it has the Cadillac emblem when it still had the ducks.
Yes.
It's kind of an interesting thing to note.
And I didn't know about the ducks until you told me today. But
I guess the emblem has morphed over
actually,
time.
The little
it's
emblem,
evolved.
The crest it's called. There's the wings and the crest.
Right.
The crest has, in these days, had little ducks in them. And I'll show them to you. I didn't even notice them until Christian called my attention to it.
The
I was
emblem.
Looking at the floor mats, and they were in the floor mats and on the steering wheel.
Because it's kind of like a boat, is that?
Yeah!
Well,
it's very similar to a boat.
We'll have to find out what the ducks are all about. I'm not sure.
The car was restored by a fellow by the name of Tony Hiller.
Tony Hiller.
Tony Hiller is well known in the Cadillac LaSalle Club in Southern California. He goes out, he's a real Cadillac enthusiast. He has a Cadillac crest and wings tattoo. And
does he have the ducks?
I don't know if he's got the ducks on his tattoo or not, but we'll have to check it out. We'll see.
And
it's a six-passenger with a six-body trunk.
So you could definitely have a nice vacation. You take all the luggage you need.
Yeah, as long as you don't want to get somewhere very fast. It's you know, it's a cruiser. It goes down the highway, very comfortable at about 60 miles an hour. But in those days, those cars weren't meant to go real fast like they are today. You know, it doesn't have disc brakes, and it doesn't have the power steering is. You know, a lot of power steering to the power steering. It's, you know, so it's kind of loose.
Right.
So you have to pay attention when you're going down the road because it's very similar to driving a boat.
I've heard that. It's,
it's
a little bit like suggesting to the car. Which...
Yes, yeah. It suggests where it wants to go. You have to correct it to go to where you want to go.
And plan ahead.
Yes, it is. Plan ahead for your stops. Not a lot of weaving in and out of traffic.
But then it's always so smooth.
Oh, it's just wonderful to ride in.
Yeah.
It's wonderful to ride in.
Well, what a pleasure to see this here.
Thank you.
And love the fins at that point. We're starting to come back down, but still very, very horizontal with the rest of the language. A wonderful example. Thank you so much for bringing it here.
Thank you. It was very nice
to meet you.
Yeah.
I'm a traveling man, made a lot of stuff. Over the world, and in every port, I own the heart of at least one lovely girl. Now my sweet Fräulein down in Berlin town makes my heart start to yearn, and my China doll down in old Hong Kong waits for my return.
Thank you, Auto Effigies. We had a great morning. Thoroughly enjoyed it. And we'll look forward to seeing the pictures.
I certainly endured it.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.